concert sounds of glory. The focus of tonight's concert is twofold: to highlight a high school choral program in a special and unique way, in a concert hall designed for such a purpose, and two, to acquaint the Tri-City area with the varied choral offerings in Henrico County Public Schools. This concert would not have been possible without the strong support of the Henrico County School Board, our superintendent, Dr. William Cleveland Bosher, Dr. Jolene DeMary, our assistant superintendent of instruction, and Dr. Edward Wong, director of secondary education. To all of the persons I just mentioned, a hearty, hearty thanks. A concert of this magnitude requires at least a year's preparation in advance. Mrs. Lee Hanshee, choral director at Henrico High School, readily accepted the responsibility of being co-chairman for this event. At this time, I have to say publicly to you that I have never had a person to work harder and to be more dedicated to a cause. And I want to publicly say to Mrs. Lee Hanshee, I love you and I thank you so much for your heartfelt work. Tonight, we have two outstanding vocal instructors from Virginia Union participating in our concert. They are Mr. Martin Stroger, an outstanding performer and voice instructor at Virginia Union University, and Mr. Marvin Curtis, an outstanding choral director, instructor, and composer. And just before I arrived on stage, he shared with me he's been asked to do the music for the inauguration for President Clinton. So we are excited, our young people are excited, and it's now time to move on with the concert. Sit back and relax and enjoy the 1992 Sounds of Glory.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's special evening of choral music. My name is Martin Strother, and I will be your announcer tonight. It is with great pride and pleasure that our Henrico School Board Superintendent, administrative personnel, and the high school choral teachers present our students performing in this historic building. The choral teachers and students wish to thank all of the persons mentioned above. And at this time, we would like to express our special thanks to Mr. Rex Britton, our conductor. Also participating in the orchestra tonight are music teachers, students from Henrico County's high schools, and the wonderful members and musicians from the Richmond Symphony Orchestra. We also wish to thank our specialist, music specialist, Mrs. Shirley Diggs. Diggs is loved by all who come in contact with her for her unfailing support, encouragement, and enthusiastic approach to making wonderful things happen for the youth of Henrico County. And we are indeed pleased that you are here tonight, and we know that you will enjoy this glorious concert by our fantastic Henrico County musicians. Our theme tonight is Sounds and Glory. As the old saying goes, let's get on with the show. Let's begin tonight's concert with the singing of our national anthem, arranged for solo trumpet and a cappella choir, conducted tonight by Mrs. Shirley Diggs. Please welcome Mrs. Diggs and the 519 voice combined choirs.
Lord, oh, sing his praise. Oh, sing, bless his name, oh, bless his name. Shout for joy before the Lord. Come before the Lord with praise.
Hallelujah, sing.
Oh, sing to the Lord.
Thank you.
Miss Miller works at the Virginia Randolph School teaching general music. In the summer, Miss Miller is the choral director and accompanist for the Virginia Girls State Glee Club. Before moving to Henrico, Miss Miller also directed music at Promised Land Baptist Church in Appomattox County. She is also an excellent pianist and organist.
Thank you.
proud to introduce and a proponent of quality education for all students in Henrico County, our superintendent, Dr. Wim Boscher.
Thanks so much, Martin, and thank you for all the support tonight. I know that we have lots of teachers in the audience who are confident that environment is the key to success, but we've got hundreds of parents in the audience who know that genetics, right? Music comes from genetics. As a matter of fact, wherever it comes from, it's beautiful to hear. You notice that in secondary schools and high schools, we're not worried about being politically correct. We still sing about points of light. The support that you've given to this program. I know that in the beginning you heard lots of thanks, but we can't overstate that. Shirley and Lee and Rex and Martin, who's provided the coordination for tonight, I want you to help me to thank them again. They're somewhere that they can hear you, because they'll tend to just move away after it's over with and not be recognized. But would you put them together for me for those? People like Howard Rogers, who's the chairman of our school board, and Kay Sears, the vice chairman, Bob Hall, Tom Beasy, who are here, Craig Thompson. I want to thank them for their support. I would also note that we weren't planning to do this again this year. We had talked years ago about filling a stadium with young people. And tonight, when 519 are on stage, and you have to realize that the first year that Shirley asked me to do this, I was honored. Then she told me that it was actually a filler, so she could get them back on the stage, and that's what they're doing right now. But when you know that, when you see Shirley come out, so I can't see you, all of you look over here, when you see her come out, you'll know I'm finished. But John Waldrop came along with Howard Rogers and said, why aren't we doing it again? It reminded me very much of a businessman who came up after the first one and said, Bill, we need to do this every year. And in truth, for us, we might skip a year and it sounds like something in a budget cycle, but in reality, every time we skip a year, we've skipped some of them. And we need to keep it going, because those sounds... When I thought about the theme, Sounds of Glory, that our colleagues put together, I thought particularly for the last day. For people like Howard Rogers, who's the chairman of our school board, and Kay Sears, the vice chairman, Bob Hall, Tom Beasy, who are here, Craig Thompson, I want to thank them for their support. I would also note that we weren't planning to do this again this year. We had talked years ago about filling a stadium with young people. And tonight, when 519 are on stage, and you have to realize that the first year that Shirley asked me to do this, I was honored. Then she told me that it was actually a filler, so she could get them back on the stage. And that's what they're doing right now. But when you know that, when you see Shirley come out, so I can't see you, all of you look over here, when you see her come out, you'll know I'm finished. You're out of your camp. But John Waldrop came along with Howard Rogers and said, why aren't we doing it again? It reminded me very much of a businessman who came up after the first one and said, Bill, we need to do this every year. And in truth, for us, we might skip a year and it sounds like something in a budget cycle, but in reality, every time we skip a year, we've skipped some of them. And we need to keep it going, because those sounds... back and I thought about the theme, Sounds of Glory, that our colleagues put together. I thought particularly for the last day and a half I've been in West Virginia, I understand why it's almost heaven. But I've been in West Virginia working with young people in two cities there, Charleston and Beckley, on drug and alcohol abuse. They had big conferences, and there's been something that's been very much with me, because I mentioned to each that I lost both of my grandparents out here on 360 near Mechanicsville 21 years ago when five people in an automobile came up with no lights and all of them were drunk and they swept them away. I'm sure that neither of them ever knew what hit them. And so often I've wanted to retrieve them, because what a senseless way to take life from people. And yet I remember that my grandmother used to say something when she was excited. I can hear it now. She would say, "Glory be." She'd slap her leg. "Glory be, yes. Glory be." As a matter of fact, I've looked up the word. I'm sure as an English major, someone would have told me that that was absolutely incorrect. And yet the message came across. As a matter of fact, glory is recognition, it's honor, fame, it's adoration. Some of you tonight have been listening with us and you hear melodies that are secular. And I hear them with you. Some of you hear sounds of a Judeo-Christian ethic. And I hear them with you. Some of you hear technical skills that are amazing. And I hear them with you. But the sounds of glory tonight are your children. If my grandmother were here, I'm convinced that she would say, "Glory to be. Yes, glory to be." Us to work with your young people. We love them.
And I can read his righteous sentence. Oh,